Hello, welcome everyone. In this lecture, we're going to introduce power systems, our new subject for electrical engineers. So this is the first lecture of the series, Introduction to Power Systems. So what is a power system? Power system is a network that contains generation, transmission, distribution, and protection systems. So power system network is the largest man-made network on the earth. Its major objective is to generate, transmit, distribute the electrical energy. So power system contains many components like generators, transformers, circuit breakers, transmission lines, synchronous motors, induction motors, relays, insulators, compensators, etc. The system contains a large set of components which are interconnected to achieve our objective of efficient energy transmission to the customers. So before going that, we have to understand few terms. T. What is utility? Utility is a entity or a body that does generation, transmission, distribution of electrical energy and brings the electrical energy to the customer premises. That is, all the system and the process that is involved in bringing down electrical supply to our household or to the customer premises is called as the term utility. And the scope and responsibility of the utility is still customer premises. So if you look at your house, the electrical supply wires enter into your energy meter. After that, the electricity is distributed to all the loads in your house. So the scope of the utility is still the customer premises, that is still energy meter of your house or building or your complex. So example for utilities are all state electrical boards, in Kerala State Electricity Board. Likewise, all the state electricity boards which generate and transmit their own power, they come under the category of utilities. So customer, who is a customer? Customer is the one who pays and purchases the electrical energy from the utility and pays the tariff. So again, customers are classified into domestic customers like household customers, commercial customers like commercial complexes, buildings, shops, etc. There is a municipal loads like municipal customers and industrial customers who take energy for their industrial applications. The scope and responsibility of the customer, once the electrical connection enters the meter, after this metering panel, the complete distribution of the electrical supply is under customer's scope. He will be responsible for any hazards that happen within his scope, that is after metering station. Now, if you vaguely understand how the power system works, if you can see, electricity or electrical energy is generated at generating stations. Usually the generation voltage will be from 11 kV to 13 kV. Nowadays it is up from 11 kV to, we are generating power electricity at voltages from 11 kV to 30 kV. Okay, next, after that there will be a step up transformer which steps up the voltage from lower voltage to higher voltage, usually in the range of 200 to 500 kV. And then this is a primary transmission. Again, there will be a step down transformer, that is a substation where the voltage is stepped down from that high voltage to medium voltage. Usually the step down occurs. Suppose this is a 500 kV line. So the steps down, let us say it is occurring from 500 kV to say 132 kV. Again, the secondary transmission occurs from 132 kV. Again, in the vicinity of any town or a city, there would be again a stepping down transformer housed in the substation. Suppose here it is stepping down the voltage from 132 kV to, let us say, 132 kV on HT side to 33 kV or 11 kV, any voltage. So this Stepping down after this, the distribution, primary distribution starts. Primary distribution again is carried by three-phase, three-wire system. So again, here it will be stepped down to the nominal voltage. Suppose the primary voltage is 33 kV. It will be stepped down from 33 kV to 415 volts. So again, it would be distributed at 415 volts to the domestic customers. So vaguely, you have a generation, you have a step-up transformer, transmission, again step-down transformer, again the secondary transmission, again you are stepping down the voltages and bringing down to the voltage levels which we have to distribute to the customers. Industrial customers can be directly fed at higher voltages, say at, they may be fed at 132 kV or 33 kV directly, depending upon the requirement. Next important term is nominal voltage. All voltages in power system network are expressed as line-to-line RMS voltages. At any point, if you look, the voltage is expressed as a line-to-line RMS voltage. Only at the single-phase customer end, the voltage is expressed as the phase-to-neutral RMS voltage. Suppose if you take a 3-pin plug point of our house, you can see what is the voltage between the phase and neutral. The voltage between phase and neutral is 230 volt phase-to-neutral RMS voltage. So only at the single phase customer premises the voltage is expressed as phase to neutral RMS voltage. Apart from this, at all points in power system the voltage is expressed as line to line RMS voltages. For example, again, what is a nominal voltage? The voltage that we are supposed to get at a point is a nominal voltage. For example, if you ask what is the voltage we are supposed to get between in our 3-pin plug point, it is 230 volt. If you will say it is 230 volt. But if you take a multimeter and measure the actual voltage, your actual voltage will never be equal to 230 volt. Always there will be a fluctuation from the, there will be deviation from the 230 volt. So suppose if you take 100 samples in a day, if you measure the voltage between phase and neutral of your 3-pin plug point 100 times in a day, not even a single time you will be able to achieve exact 230 volts. So the actual voltage will be plus or minus this 230 volt. So we call this 230 volt as the nominal voltage, the voltage which we are supposed to get at a particular point. Okay. So your actual voltage will be slightly different from the nominal voltage. Now if you look at the a portion of the previous diagram, here you can see, suppose computer whose voltage is 11 kV, that means the voltage between the two phases of this distributor is 11 kV. Okay, so this 11 kV is the nominal voltage. The voltage that is supposed to be present in this distributor is 11 kV. Again, there is a step down transformer that steps down voltage from 11 kV to 415 volt. Then what is the voltage of this distributor, 3-phase 4-wire distributor? Here it is 415 volt. So at every point there is a specific voltage which the system has to maintain. That voltage is called nominal voltage and it is always line to line RMS value. But the actual voltage may be slightly in variation with the nominal. Nominal voltage is a voltage which the system has to maintain at a specified point in the power system network. So if you understand power system, if you look at power system, what exactly we are doing in a power system? In power system, we are selling the electrical energy to the customer. So if you look at the power system as a business, where our commodity is electrical energy, we are selling electrical energy and the unit is 1 kilowatt hour. If you calculate 1 kilowatt hour, 1 kilowatt hour is nothing but 3.6 million joule of energy. Understand? So in this business, who will supply the electrical energy? Utility is the one who is supplying electrical energy to the customers. So what are the objectives of utility? In any business, the ultimate objective is profit. And second objective is customer satisfaction, satisfying all the customers who are purchasing electrical energy from us. When you come to the perception of the customer, what are the customer demands in this business? He wants cheap electrical energy. That means electrical energy at cheaper unit prices. And reliability. What is reliability? 24/7. He should get the electrical supply should be available for him to consume. And the third one is the quality electrical energy. So these are the three demands of the customer he require: cheap electrical energy, 24/7 reliable electrical supply, and quality electrical energy. Next, we'll see what is quality. What do you mean by quality electrical energy? How do you quantify the quality of electrical energy? So quality electrical energy should have three parameters. The first one is the voltage should be within plus or minus 5% of nominal voltage. That is, the actual voltage, as we have seen, it should be plus or minus 5% of the nominal voltage at any point in the power system. What is the frequency? The frequency should be within plus or minus 1% of the nominal frequency. What is nominal frequency in India? 50 hertz is our nominal frequency. So your actual frequency can fluctuate plus or minus of this 1%. Then we say that the frequency is within the proper 50 hertz. The allowable range for frequency is from 49.5 to 50 hertz. And the third important parameter that decides quality is that whatever the voltage wave that you are getting, it should be free from harmonics. So the cosinusoidal voltage wave which we are getting at our customer premises, it should be a pure cosinusoidal wave. It should be free from harmonics. So if the electrical supply that you are receiving, if it maintains all these three parameters within this allowable tolerance range, then we say we are getting the quality electrical energy. Then what are the basic challenges we face to supply quality electrical energy? Why to maintain fixed frequency, to maintain our frequency at 50 hertz, what is the challenge? We have to maintain real power balance in our power system at all the time. Sir, what do you mean by real power balance? So you should input the shaft power or mechanical input coming from prime mover is the input, and what is the output? Output is the electrical power. Output is PE. So there should be always a balance between this mechanical input and the electrical output of the machine. That means for all time, if your PS is equals to PE for all time t, then your frequency will be 50 hertz. So what is the difficulty here? The amount of electrical power which we have to generate should be equal to the amount of demand, load demand, plus transmission and distribution losses. So in this parameter, the load and the transmission losses are always fluctuating. They are not constant. So what will happen to the load in the next instant, we will not be able to know. So adjusting our shaft power, that means adjusting our shaft power to the fluctuating load demands is a challenging task. So adjusting the generation according to fluctuating load is the main challenge, because whenever there is a fluctuation in load, to maintain that fluctuation intact, to maintain this balance, what we have to do, we have to adjust the shaft power. So the major problem rises because electrical load can fluctuate instantaneously, whereas the shaft power that is coming from the turbine cannot be changed instantaneously. There is some time lag in the governor system. So that creates the challenge, that creates the difficulty in maintaining constant frequency. The next is to maintain a constant voltage at every point in the power system. That means to maintain the voltage of a power system equal to the nominal voltages, the major challenge is that we have to maintain reactive power balance in the system. So if you take a generator, the problem here to maintain, we have to adjust the excitation such that the total reactive power generated by all sources put together should be equal to total reactive power lost in the transmission and distribution and total reactive power demand of the load at all time. If we maintain this reactive power balance, then the actual voltage at every point will be equal to the nominal voltage. So again, as the load is fluctuating, Again, as the load is fluctuating, your reactive power loss in the transmission and distribution and your reactive power demanded by the load is continuously changing. So adjusting the generation of reactive power according to the load fluctuations is a challenging task. That's why there are fluctuations in the voltage in the system. So what are the challenges in our electrical power system? The first and major challenge arises from the fact that electrical energy has to be generated, transmitted at the same instant of demand. That means whatever electrical energy that you are consuming in your house or in your office at this moment, it has to be generated, transmitted and distributed at the same instant, because there is no provision to store electrical energy in bulk quantities. There is no buffer of electrical energy. The electrical energy has to be generated, transmitted at the same instant of demand. So that is a very big challenge. Next, maintaining voltage and frequency fluctuations within the operating range while meeting the fluctuation in load is the biggest challenge. We know that our real power demand and reactive power demand and losses are continuously fluctuating because of the load changes. We have to maintain the generation of the real power and the reactive power from the sources equal to this load fluctuations, because to maintain the constant voltage and frequency is a really challenging task in the power system. Maintaining high reliability and safety of power system network is the next challenge in our electrical power system. And reducing the cost of generation, maintaining high transmission efficiency and optimum utilization of the installed generating capacities. So the same load demand can be met in n different ways by allocating different loads to the generator. But however, at each and every point of time, we should strive to minimize the total cost of generation. So these are the major challenges of electrical power system. So thank you for this lecture.